about when he said, do not get saved as a believer. Someone gets saved as a non-believer. The same way a cancer can knock at somebody else's door who is not a believer can also come to my life and knock at my door. That's life. And we have Jesus to help us with that. When other people who does not have Jesus definitely don't have. But if people come to you and say, oh, how come? Well, how come? This is life. What can I do? But the difference is, I can go to Jesus and ask for a solution. I can go to Jesus and ask for healing, for understanding, for his comfort, for whatever you need. You go to Jesus. And that is the difference. Well, Pastor, but I know someone who was so good. He was such a woman of God and such a man of God and died a terrible death. I have two friends. If you or mine, I've known someone as well. What does it prove? What does it prove? It proved that he was alive, she was alive. Unfortunately, he died a terrible death. It does not change God. And the Bible said that it's pleasant to God the death of his saints. Which means, if I die a terrible death, although it's terrible here on earth, in heaven, I'll get there with glories.
Amen.
Because when I get in heaven, God is waiting for me.
Amen.
That's what God sees. Mm-hmm. Oh, but why God heals some people and don't heal others? Well, you better ask God then, because I don't have the answer for you. But somehow, in his power and grace and love, he heals some and let others die or follow the course of life. It does not change God. It does not change his love for you. But one thing I know for sure. One thing I know for sure. Turn to someone and say, Pastor knows something for sure.
Pastor knows something for sure.
No matter how it is, how bad it is, God is with you all the way.
Amen.
And right when you get in heaven, hey, if I'm there before you, I'll make sure to go to the door and wake you up. Hey, come on, wake up, wake up. If you come first, please. Therefore, whatever you want man to do to you, do also to them. Do you like people be nice to you? So please be nice to people. Find ways to bless people. I've been blessed by non-believers in so many ways that teach me to be a blessing to those I know and to those I don't. Well, we need to be cautious about that, definitely. You need to be a light, whatever you are.
Yes.
You need to be salt, whatever you are. You need to be that person that makes a difference. You don't even need to speak. But you are the presence of Jesus where you are. That is the difference. You cannot just be another one. You cannot just be another part or not. No, no, no. You are the person Jesus assigned you to be. This is powerful. And that's what the world wants you to do. The world wants you to be. The world wants you to be like everybody else. So you kind of get mingled in the crowd. Or in the clouds. Clouds and clouds. You're not. Jesus was not. The disciples were not. Because they make a difference. I'm not trying to say to you, I'm not definitely saying to you that you should be different because you want to be different, because you want to carry yourself as a different person. No, I'm not saying that. We're different because we have Jesus Christ, and our set of values are different. Let's move on to verse 7. You still? Matthew chapter 7, verse 7. Now Jesus again introduced another principle. And he said, ask, and it will be given to you. Seek, then you will find. Knock, and it will be opened to you. Matthew 7, 7. In my heart, so many times over, in times of conflict, in times of spiritual challenges, in times of danger, I always remember Matthew 7, 7.
The
promise of Jesus. A principle laid down there.
Ask,
and it will be given to you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and it will be open to you. Well, let me bring to your attention, maybe you know it, but something that I found very interesting. The word ask here, the verb to ask, that Jesus applied is different. But Jesus uses the word for prayer when he is talking about your prayer and my prayer. He never uses the same word when he uses I'm going to pray. Jesus and for me. And then he keep going in verse 8. And it says, for everyone who asks receives. Now his you know, the application here. The explanation, I should say. For everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks find, and to him who knocks it will be opened. When he said the word ask in the sense of begging, it doesn't mean that you are a beggar. It doesn't mean that you are destitute. What Jesus means is you have no rights. That's how you approach, how I approach God. Jesus taught also, blessed are those, you know, who are meek, who are poor in spirit. That approach. I come to God understanding that I'm nothing. He is God. And so it's not the attitude, it's not that posture of, oh please God, oh please God, I'm not begging you. No, no, no. That's not the model here. I hope you understand that. It's because we have nothing for us that will make God see us as, okay, yes, we deserve something. No. We have it. We deserve it because of Jesus Christ. Everything by grace. And God does it because he loves us. And he doesn't see you as a beggar. He sees you as a son, a daughter, because that's how the Bible shows us before God. Okay? But that's the word that Jesus used. And then he says, for everyone who asks, receive, and who seeks, find, and to whom who knocks, it will be open. Okay, for the scholars on the Greek language, actually it comes in the present continuous form, meaning this, for those who keep asking, for those who keep seeking, for those who keep knocking, it will be open. Because you may be one of those people say, I've already talked to God. If you want to answer, he answers. Well, there's a pride right there, sir. There's a pride out there. The Bible says if you keep asking, if you keep knocking, if you keep searching, it will be open to you. It doesn't mean that you don't trust in God. It means it is important for you. God definitely listened to you the first time you prayed. But you're seeking, you're knocking, shows how important it is for you. And for some reason, that's the way Jesus put it here. And he explains it. For what a man is there among you who, if his own son asks for bread, will give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will give him a serpent? Then he explained, if you then, being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father who is in heaven give good things to those who ask you? Okay, Jesus is explaining here this. God knows what you need. And he will never give you the wrong thing. He will never give you what you do not need. That's why Jesus went so practical as to explain, giving the disciple an illustration about a parent and their children. For those of us who are parents, we know if our kids ask us for something, of course we try our best to give what they ask. Do. Not because it's good or bad, it's because it is not right. But if someone is starting introducing world values to you, values that for the world be simple and acceptable and right, and you just take it into consideration, what happens is this will eventually deceive you and come into your being, and you're going to start incorporating it, and then you start being like those Christians that would not know what you're talking about, but you just want to be okay, you just want to be politically correct, And you're going to say, well, the Bible accommodates every belief, and the Bible accommodates this and accommodates that. And after you, the one accommodating the world, but the Bible so clearly said, please be aware.